Sorry, when I love.
Okay. We will start the session. Sit in any convenient position. Anytime if I am not audible or not visible, please help me so I'll correct myself. So today's session is for preparing for the month of June. So all the practices which we are going to do in the month of June, I'm trying to explain today. So let's start with the prayer. Always with your back straight. Inhaling, take the arms over the head. So your elbow will be straight when your arm goes up. Then when you're exhaling, bring your hands to the center of the heart. So this is the heart center. Eyes are closed. Take inhalation. Trayambakam yajamahe sugandhim pushtivardhanam urvarukamiva bandhana mrityormukshiyamamrudad. Om. Inhaling, take the arm straight up through the center. Elbow will become straight. Then exhaling, bring the hands down, making a good circle out of it. And bring your hands to Dhyana Mudra. This month, the loosening practices are from supine position. So every month we try to change the practices. And it repeats after 2 or 3 months. So I lie down. Those who want to observe, please observe. This class is more for observation, not for doing. If you want to do, you can do, but observation and learning is the purpose of this class. First message to be given. If you see my camera, I have kept my camera in such a way that my full mat is visible. See, this is the way you should arrange. Don't do any changes now. I'm just giving you the right methods to attend an online class. You can see my full mat is visible. And if I stand up, I am fully visible. You can see when I go to left, if I go to right, whatever I do, I am fully visible to you. See, so this is the way you should place your camera. In Zoom, there is an option called HD, HD and original video. There are two options. If you go to video settings, if you click that, it actually increases the span of the camera. So both those things, if you check box, I mean tick mark that, your span of your camera may improve. Just try next time, okay? If you have limited space. So I lie down. I'm going to start my loosening practices. So I keep my legs together, hands close to the body. So just observe if you want. Inhaling, point your toes forward. Exhaling, point it backward. Inhale, front. Exhale, back. Inhale, front. Exhale, back. Inhale, front. Pointing the toe. Exhale, back. One more. Inhale, front. And exhale, back. Now rotate the feet. One. All the direction. Two. Three. Four. Five. Change. One. Two. Here, normal breathing. Three. Four. Note my palms are facing the mat. Five. Now, bend both the legs. Keep the feet close to the buttocks on the mat. Inhaling, stretch the left leg. Exhaling, bend it. Inhale, right leg. Exhale, bend. Inhale, left. Exhale, bend. Watch my toe. Inhale, right. pointed toe. Exhale, bent. Inhale, left. Exhale, bent. Inhale, right. And exhale, bend. Now together. Inhale, up. Exhale, bend. Inhale, two. Exhale, bend. Inhale, three. Just straightening the leg. Exhale, bend. Watch my toe. Inhale, four. Exhale. You have to keep it back on the mat, not in the air. Inhale, five. And exhale, bend. Inhaling, spread both the arms sideways. Bring it to shoulder level. Here my hand is a little, no space, so I'm just keeping it like this. So inhaling, I open my arm sideways. Exhale, tilt both the knees to the left and look at the right hand. Inhale, bring it back. Exhale, tilt my knees to the right and look at the left hand. Inhale, up, look up. Exhale, left, look right. Inhale, up. Exhale, right, look left. Inhale, up. Three times each. Exhale, left. Spinal twisting. Inhale, up. Also called as Markatasana. Exhale, right. Inhale, up. One more. Exhale, left. Inhale. See, I'm not replacing the feet. Exhale, right. And inhale, up. Exhale, arm down, leg down. Inhale, take both the arms over the head, keep it on the ground. Just exhale the breath, keep the legs together and pointed. Inhale, left leg up, 90 degree. Exhale, bring it down. Inhale, right. Exhale, down. Inhale, left. Exhale, down. Inhale, right. Only that leg moves. Exhale, down. Inhale, left. Three times each. Exhale, down. Inhale, right. And exhale, down. Now together. Inhale, one. Exhale, slowly down. Inhale, two. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Five times. Exhale. One more. Inhale. Now stay there for 10 numbers. 1, 2. Looking at the toe. 3, 4. Is the hip lifting? No. 5, 6. Legs are 90. 7, 8. Breathe normal. 9, 10. Exhale. Bring the leg down. Inhale in the position. Exhale, hands down. Take one or two breaths here. Then going to cycling. Pavanamuktasana crunches. So inhale, take both the legs up 30 degree. And then exhale, bring your hands here. Okay. Bend left leg, touch. Chin on the left knee. Change. Right. Okay, you can hold. Left. Change. Right. Change. Left. Change. Right. Change. Left. Change. Right. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. One more. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale and exhale. Then inhale, head down, leg down. Exhale, release the leg. So that's called Pavanamuktasana crunches. So you don't have to take the arms over your head. You can just bend the leg, hug the knee first, keeping both the legs in the air like this. Then touch, inhale. Touch, inhale, that way, okay? After that, leg down, head down. Exhaling, release both the hands and your leg down. So that's called Pavanamuktasana crunches. After doing this much, we have to turn. So inhale, take the right arm over the head, bend your left leg. When you're exhaling, turn to the ground. After turning around, keep your palm by the side of the chest. Now, cobra breathing. So inhale, lift your upper body, whatever possible.
lift, whatever you can do. Exhale, come down.
5 times, this also. Inhale, 2.
Exhale.
Gradually improve the arch. Inhale.
Exhale. See, my elbow should not be spreading.
Inhale.
Exhale.
One more, last. Inhale.
Now stay for some time. 1. It is preparing the back arch. 3. 4. Open the shoulder. 5. Exhale, come down.
Now inhale, come to cat position. When you're exhaling, turn to the front. Now keep your inhaling, keep your knees together, knees apart, feet apart, standing toes. Exhale, be ready. We are going to do Marjiriyasana level 2. Inhale, stretch the left arm, right leg, front and back. Exhale, fold them, elbow touch the knee. Inhale, 2. Exhale, fold. Inhale, 3. Exhale, fold. Inhale, 4. Exhale, fold. One more. Inhale, 5. Stay there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, elbow touch the knee. 1, 2, 3. Maintain. 4. In the air only. 5. Inhale to cat position.
Exhale.
Now, other side. Inhale, 1. Exhale, 2, exhale, 3, four, one more, 5, stay there, 1, 2, breathe, 3, arm up, leg up, 4, 5, exhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Inhale to cat position. And exhale, sit Vajrasana. After sitting, you can just keep your hands on your thigh. Then we do arm loosening. So bring the arms in front. Fist close, open, close, open, close, open, close, open, close, open, palm, drop, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, one more, down, up, fist close, wrist rotate, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, reverse, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, hands on shoulder, straighten the arm, fold, straight, fold, straight, fold, straight, fold, straight, one more, fold, straight, fold the arm, touch the elbow front, shoulder rotate, 1, 2, 3, 4, see the synchronization of the breath, 5, change, 1, 2, 3, backward, upward, and come back, 4, with control on the muscle, 1 more, 5, interlock the finger, inhale, stretch my arms to the sky, long back, 1, elbow will not bend, 2, shoulder touching the ear, 3, normal breathing, 4, long back, 5, exhale, hands down, inhale, sit to one side, exhale, release the legs in front, hands back, shake your legs. Last 2 loosening practices, neck rotation. After some time, stop shaking, put chin on chest. Close your eye, neck rotate. 1. Those who are practicing today, you are essentially loosened with me. 2. Rotate your neck. 3.
Inhalation
and exhalation. 4. One more circle.
5.
Change. 1.
All side.
2. 3. 4. Last one. 5. That's it. Then keep the legs together. Last loosening practice, forward bending. Inhale, take the arms sideways up. Make it parallel. Exhale, bend forward. Try to touch your feet. Inhale, sit up. Again. Exhale, down. Inhale, 3. Exhale. Little more deeper. Inhale. Exhale. Last one. Inhale. And exhale. Stay for some time. 1. 2. Keep on pulling gradually. 3. 4. Last moment. Put the head down. 5. Inhale, sit up, hands up. Exhale, hands down. Samasthiti. That completes loosening practice of this month. It takes about 10 to 12 minutes. Yeah. Okay. Any clarifications required on loosening practice? Otherwise, I go to the Surya Namaskara this month.
Sir, in cobra pose, is your feet together or is it away from each other?
No, it is together. I try to keep them as close as possible. When you lift up, your heel or toe may go a little away. Just be aware of it. Try to keep them together. Sometimes it may not be together, but try to keep them as much as possible.
Okay, sir.
In cobra position, the feet is always together.
And knee should touch ground only, right?
Yeah, knees are on the ground. When you do that cobra, knees are, it is not your upward facing dog and dog. Here, it is just back arch.
As much as you can, gradually increase the height. So the legs are together and knees are on the mat. Knees will not lift.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Whereas when you do Surya Namaskara,
the knees are in the air. It's lifted up. It's lifted up, right? It's not lifted.
Yes. Yes.
Anything else? Okay, we have completed the loosening practice. Going up is
sir, you often say during Chandra Namaskara, pull your body forward and then do the cobra pose.
Ah, yeah. See, many people, they are doing like this. See, from here, when you go down, some people are doing like this. See, where is the body? The body is behind the... Now, if you do that, your back pain will come. See, the arm is in front, body is fully at the back. You'll get a back pain because the full load comes here. Now, show me how to, I'll tell you, show you how to pull and lift like this.
Where is the chest? The chest in, came in front. Now, the relatively the lower body is less loaded. So, I came up front and lift. You should not lift directly from there. You have to pull like this. See, pull up. So the chest comes in front. Now many people do this much only. The chest will remain back of the arm. Where is the chest? Is the chest in front or back?
Behind, yeah, back.
Chest has to come here.
Okay. So that will require a lot of arm strength to pull the body forward.
Otherwise, what will happen? Lower back problem. L3, L4, L5, sub. No, lafda hone wala hai. Okay. Yeah, you have to pull. Yeah, cobra is pull. Okay, I'm not talking about this one. In cobra, it will not cause much problem because knee is resting on the floor. So in case you're not able to do that, I mean, this action comes in Urdhva Mukha Svanasana, upward facing dog. If your knee and thigh is resting on the floor, it is not going to cause much problem. But if you are lifting the knee and thigh from the floor and your chest is behind the arm, then the full load will come in the lumbar spine. This lumbar spine will take a load. You can yourself feel it. The arms are not taking the load. These are the things, no? You have to analyze.
So for those of us who cannot do it right now, what is the modification for this?
You keep the knee down. Don't worry, just keep the knee down. This much is enough. See, here it is safe because my knee is resting on the floor. With the backbone will not take weight. The knee, thigh is taking the weight. It's safe. But if you're lifting this, in this position it's dangerous. If you're lifting, then you have to come front. If you're lifting the knee from the floor.
Got it, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Okay. I'm going to the, this month it is Soham Surya Namaskara, which contains one Shashankasana. So let me show you two rounds of that. Then I'll go to the asana practices. Always start from front. Never start from here and also Namaskara. I've seen some people doing that. And then suddenly they realize, oh, I have to go forward. My mat is long, that's why I'm standing here. I can take my leg quite comfortably back. Samasthiti, feet together, hands tight. Inhale, arms over the head. Exhale, heart. See, my breath is audible. I'm not saying that your breath should be fully loud. No. Yet the indicator of right breathing is that your breath sound will come. That hissing noise of the throat will come if you're breathing properly. That's the indicator that I'm controlling my breath. So it will not be like this. That's not right. You have to control your breath. Then close the eyes, inhale. Hiranmayena patrena satyasyapi hitam mukham. Tattvam pushanna pavrano satya dharmaya drishtaye. Om. Inhale, open the eyes. Exhale, gaze on your nose. Take one Ujjayi breath. Ekam. Inhale, stretch the arms backward.
Dvi. Exhale and bend forward.
Pruni. Left leg. Inhale, take it back.
Chatwari, exhale the right.
Pancha, inhale knee down. Exhale, sit back.
Shat, inhale come up on the knee.
Exhale, knee chin chest on the mat. Sapta, slip the toe away, inhale chest up.
Ashta. Exhale and lift the back. Nava. Inhale left leg forward.
Dasha.
Exhale the right. Ekadasha. Stand up. Inhale, stretch the arm backward.
Exhale, namaskar.
Om Mitraya Namaha. Second round. Ekam.
Dvi.
Trini right.
Chatwari.
Pancha.
Shat.
Satta.
Ashta. Nava, right.
Dasha.
Ekadasha.
Dvadasha.
Om Ravaye Namaha. So this round will be 11 and the last round we'll be holding. All those positions we'll be holding one round. That is the sequence for Surya Namaskara Soham this month. Any doubts? Otherwise, I go to the asana practices.
Sir, you always tell in the mountain pose to put our heels down. So, can we move our heels a little forward and then put the heels down?
Yes, you can do that. So you don't. So if you keep like this, no, it may be very tough. See, it's very difficult. See, it's too much far. I cannot keep only. Very difficult for me. See, how will you do like this? Very far. This I am good. See. So there is a proper distance for all of us.
Okay, sir.
It should not be here. It should not be here. Keep it the correct distance.
Okay, sir.
Who is that?
But what? If I put it a little close, the next step, when where we put our leg in front, I can't do it. I cannot do the put the leg front.
Okay, keep it here. Okay, keep it here. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Any other doubts?
Sir, you ask me to means in this asana.
Which one?
This one.
That one. You're either going like this. I'll show you. You're either like this or like this.
Like that. Yes.
That's the problem. You have to keep mid. See the mid. You have to find where is the middle point. This is the mid. You're going like this or like this. You find it out.
Yes.
Any other queries? Done. Going to standing postures. First, Parsha Konasana, Parivartha Parsha Konasana, Ardha Chandrasana, Malasana. In one sequence, I'm going to finish all of them. In advanced class, is there anybody? You have to ask me specifically. Then I'll show those asanas. Samasthiti. So I was here, right? I finished my Surya Namaskara here. So and then we do those eye rotations, which are remaining the same. Eye rotations and your Uddhyana Bandha, Agnisara Kriya. There is no change in any of them, right? They continue. And then I say, turn to your left and go to the back of the mat. So I do that. Samasthiti. Parsha Konasana. So first I inhale here. I'm waiting for that inhale to be over. Take an exhale, right leg out 4 to 4.5 feet. See the distance. Not this much. Only this much. How will you do Parsha Konasana? Not possible. So take it out. Ekam exhale. About 4 feet. 4 to 4.5. Dui. Inhale. Turn the right foot. Look over the shoulder. Trini. Exhale. Bend this knee. Keep the right hand down. So what is this angle? 90 degree. Chatwari. Inhaling. Stretch the left arm on the left ear. That's all the asana. Start exhale. Three breaths in the pose. Inhale. See, the arm, body and the leg is in one line. If you draw a line from my heel to my hand, it is one line. Two breaths are over. Last inhalation coming. Three. So the arm is above the head level. Exhale. Left hand back, catch the waist. Look down. Shut. Inhale, stand up. Sapta. Exhale, turn. Now, do the same on the other side. So this is the first asana, Parsha Konasana. Now I will do the second asana of the series, is Parivarta Parsha Konasana. So I am going to do that in this side. I am not going to repeat the same on the other side because it's a waste of time. So after finishing both the sides, then I inhale, turn to my left. This time my full body turns. See, earlier what did I say? I said right foot turn and look over the shoulder. I did not say turn the body. I said right leg turn, look over the right shoulder, because in Parsha Konasana this arm stays in this side, it doesn't go to the other side, so I don't have to turn my body. Okay, whereas when I'm going to this side, I'm going to twist my body. Observe that. So I came back here. Now I inhale and fully turn my body and the leg. Full body turned. When I exhale, I twist my body, right arm goes to the left. Did you see that? I kept my right arm down. Then with an inhalation, I skip. Left arm. Then I start exhaling. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. One more breath. Last inhalation. Exhale, left hand back. And look down. Shut, inhale, stand up. Shoulder facing the same side. Sapta, exhale, turn. Inhaling, reduce the distance. Exhale and turn, jump forward. So that completes Parsha Konasana, Parivarta Parsha Konasana. Then I say keep the feet apart, relax a little time. Just two or three breaths. Then coming up, Ardha Chandrasana, Samasthiti. Ekam, inhale, take the arms over the head sideways. Dvi, exhale, bend forward. Keep the hands on mat. If you cannot reach, you have to use bricks. Keep the bricks and elevate the ground so that you can keep your hands on the bricks. So if you have some small small tables, though, those round tables, that also can be used. Some of you may not be able to reach the ground, so you have to keep the bricks like this, like this, like this, whichever you want, so it will be easy to reach if you cannot reach the ground, because without reaching the ground this asana cannot be done. So inhale, exhale, then inhaling the left leg goes up, then exhale here, then inhalation, take the left arm up. Exhale. Inhale, try to look at the hand. Exhale. One more breath. Exhale, arm down, leg down. Inhale, stand up. Exhale, hands down. Same method, you have to do it on the other side. What is that called? Ardha Chandrasana, half moon. So this is the second, third asana in standing. After I do complete both the sides, I go to the last asana, which is called Malasana or garland posture. With that, we complete all the standing asanas. Samasthiti. So inhale. Keep the feet almost shoulder distance apart. When you exhale, just sit and do namaste. That's all. You can keep the feet little away, V-shape and all is fine. Three breaths here. Straighten the back. So you can see, I'm pushing with my elbow and straightening the back. Did you see that? It's not like this. This is not Malasana. There is no such asana, okay? This is Malasana. You saw that difference, what I made? Do you find? So this will damage you, this will benefit you. And see the, this will really, it's, instead of doing this, do nothing. I'm telling you. If you do this, it will only, you can see my lower back. See what has happened here? You can see the bulging. It will damage my back. But if I do this, the effect is different. Okay, sitting upright and lengthening the back using your hands. That's called the garland pose, level one. Then after finishing, three breaths, inhale, keep the hands behind. And then exhale, release the legs. In advanced class, you have Prasarita Padottanasana. I think you know all that. See, anybody in the advanced class who wants to see any demonstration?
Sir, I want to see all the demonstration. I'm planning to join from this month. Muthu here.
Ah, Muthu, okay, okay. So, in your, there are two asanas extra in your advanced class. So, one is Prasarita Padottanasana. So, I'm going to quickly show you that. Samasthiti. Ekam. So, I need a, this one. Okay, Samasthiti. Ekam, inhale, take the right leg out. Almost 4 to 5 feet. Dvi, exhale, interlock of fingers. Behind. Prasarita Padottanasana. Trini, inhale, head up.
Chatvari, exhale.
You need to balance in this position. Keep on increasing the depth. Two. Three. Four. Five. Pancha, inhale, come up.
Shut, exhale, reduce the distance. Sapta, inhale, catch your waist. Ashta, exhale, turn and jump. To Samasthiti. So that's called Prasarita Padottanasana. Level C. There are four levels for it, A, B, C, D. This comes in your advanced class. Then, another asana in advanced class is Uttidahasta Padangushtasana. Samasthiti. Ekam, inhale, bend the left leg up, catch the toe and straighten the legs. On the exhalation, try to bring chin close to the left knee. Inhale, exhale, one, inhale, and exhale, try to touch. Now inhale, stand up, exhale, take the left leg. Inhale, balancing here. One, two, inhale, bring back.
Exhale, Sinandhani, one more. Inhale, stand. Exhale. Inhale. One more. Exhale, leg down. That's called Uttita Hasta Padangushtasana. It will be done on both the sides. So this is in addition to your normal class. This comes in advanced class. Now we finish all the standing postures. We go to sitting postures.
Sir, in Shirsasana, my legs do not go up. Only.
Your leg will not go up, huh?
Not on the wall. I'm not able to keep on the wall.
Okay, no problem. It will come. Keep on practicing.
Sir, okay. I had a doubt in standing asanas.
Yeah.
Sir, Artha Chakrasana, where should the drishti be?
Artha Chandrasana.
Looking Artha Chandrasana.
Tip of the hand.
Okay, sir.
Thank you. In sitting asanas, so I finished. In sitting asanas, Jana Shirsha, Parivarta Jana Shirsha, Ushtrasana, Vakrasana, Purna Navasana. I'm finishing all the three, all the five in one shot. We come to Samasthiti. Take inhalation. Back straight. Ekam exhale, left leg forward. It goes behind more than 90 degree. Dui, inhale, take the arms up. Trini, exhale, bend. Three breaths here. One. Looking at the toe. Two. Try to catch the wrist. Three. Chatwari, inhale, sit up. Then three, exhale, twist. Observe the twist. I turn my body and my arm. And chatwari, inhale, rotate the spine to the sky. Parivarta Jana Shirshasana. Exhale. Inhale. One more. Three breaths over. Exhaling, release. Pancha, inhale, sit up. Shut. Inhale and take the leg forward. Then do the same on the other side, starting with an exhalation. So that is Jana Shirsha, Parivarta Jana Shirsha. What is the complementary asana? Ushtrasana. Ekam, inhale, fold both the legs to the left. Exhale and sit Vajrasana. Take a neutralizing breath here. Three, inhale, stand up. Chatwari, exhale. Ushtrasana. One. Two. Three. Pancha. Shut. Join and sit. Sapta. Inhale, sit to the left of the feet. Why? My legs should are on the right now. Initially, how did I go? I was like this when I went up. So when I come down, I have to reverse it. There's an inhalation, sitting to the left. While exhaling, release the legs from the right. Vakrasana. Ekam, inhale, left leg bend. Left hand back. Dvi, exhale, twist the body. Catch the right toe with the left hand. Inhaling, turn the neck. Three breaths in the position. In advanced class, this shifts to Marichyasana. So in Marichyasana, what will happen? I have to swing the arm backward and swing the this hand and catch behind. That's called Marichyasana C. So this is in advanced class. In normal class, we are doing this much. So in our regular class, if people are there who can catch, you can try that also. After finishing three breaths, inhaling, look forward, release the hands. See, I'm waiting for that inhalation. Then exhale, release. Navasana. Inhale, pick up both the legs up. 90 degree. Exhale, arms in front. Not 90 degree, 60 to 70 degree. Inhale. Minimum rounding on the back. One more breath. Inhale, hand down. Exhale. Samasthiti. That's called Purna Navasana. In advanced class, Kurmasana, Supta Kurmasana will come. And Vatayanasana, that is another asana which comes in advanced class. Vatayana means horse, okay? It's also called as a horse, unicorn pose, some people call it. So, Ekam, I'm showing one side. I fold, inhale, fold my right leg and keep it in Padmasana. On the exhalation, I bend my, this is not for the intermediate batch. Bend this leg and keep it standing position. Exhalation. Now, inhaling, I have to stand up. Keeping this knee down. Exhale here. So, if this leg is in Padmasana, in standing position. Then inhale, coil the left arm above the right arm. Vatayanasana. Three breaths here. Then exhale, release the coil. Take an inhale here. Exhale, sit. Inhale, release the left leg. Exhale, the right. It's called unicorn pose or Vatayanasana. In addition to this asana, in advanced class, you've got Kurmasana, Supta Kurmasana. Avoid chatting. Tanmay, you're not supposed to chat in the class. No chatting. Don't do that.
I'm not chatting.
Yeah, okay. Samasthiti. Kurmasana, tortoise posture. And Supta Kurmasana, sleeping tortoise. Samasthiti. Inhaling, spread the legs apart. Around shoulder distance. When you exhale, bend them like two mountains. Appropriately placed. Then inhale, insert both the arms below the thigh. Straighten back outward. On the exhalation, you have to lie flat. Kurmasana. As much flat as possible.
After 3 breaths, inhale, bend the knees to the previous position. When you exhale, you have to take the binding. You have to catch the hands at the back. And then inhale, cross the legs in front of you. Cross the ankles. On the exhalation, put the hand down. Head down. Check the balance now. Three breaths here. Now inhale, head up. Exhale, unlock the leg. Inhale, release the binding.
Exhale, release the legs. That is Supta Kurmasana, Kurmasana. So that completes all the sitting asanas. Any doubts on sitting asana? Otherwise, I go to inversions.
Sir, I am not able to coil my hands.
Coil the?
Breathe out. Show me.
I cannot hear you. Coil the what?
Coil the hand, this one.
See, you tell me what you can do. What is that you have achieved? Huh? Tell me something that you started with and then now on the way you learned something. Tanmay.
Sir.
What did you learn in between? You learned something, no, you learned many things. Tell me something that you learned which you did not do in the beginning.
Wall Chakrasana.
Huh? Wall Chakrasana.
I have with wall.
Good. So keep increasing that. So gradually it will come. Don't worry, okay? It will improve, okay?
In the tortoise pose,
yeah.
Where is the drishti?
Nose. Tortoise pose, nose drishti. Okay. In binding tortoise. That is when the head is down. When you are putting the normal asana, this tortoise pose, your drishti will be on your eyebrow, looking front, eyebrow.
Okay, sir.
Then, no doubts on any other asanas, sitting asanas, janishesha, pariyurjanishesha, ushtra, vakrasana, purnanavasana. So, I go to supine posture. So, I will do sarvangasana, halasana, supta konasana, baddha konasana, markatasana. That's in one series, 5 asanas, in inversions. Samasthiti I start from. Inhale, arms over the head. Exhale, point the toe. Inhale, take both the legs up. Exhale, arm down. Now inhaling, take the legs up. One. Two. Three. Exhale, halasana. Inhale, interlock. One. Tail of the last exhale, support the back. Now inhale, spread the legs to V shape. What is it called? Supta Konasana. Brick is obstructing. In advanced class, you roll up. Trinidad Dandasana, V shape.
there is no space here. Sorry. So when you do Mera Dandasana, it open up maximum. When you open up, try to open up maximum. You're on advanced class. Shifting the weight on the sit bones. Finish the last inhale. So I will turn again so that I have to roll back. After finishing the last inhale here, exhale, roll up. To Supta Konasana. Inhale, support the back. Exhale, join the legs. Inhale, come up, Sarvanga. Exhale, do Namaste. Baddha Konasana. Widen the thighs. One more. Two. Inhale, leg up. Exhale, return. Inhale, spread the arms sideways. Exhale, keep the left leg down. Inhale here. Exhale, take the right leg to the left hand. Markatasana. Inhale, look to the other hand. Finish three breaths here. Inhale, left leg back, right leg back. Exhale, leg down. Then inhale, take the left leg up. Exhale, do Markatasana on this side. Here it is, obstruct me. Then inhale. Exhale, put the leg down. Inhale here. Exhale, hands down. Relaxing Shavasana. So that completes inversion. It takes about 6 minutes to do that. Any doubts on inversions? Anybody?
Sir,
yeah.
When I'm doing Sarvangasana, my hands are not parallel when they're supporting the back. They tend to become a slight V-shaped.
Your elbows are going away?
A bit, sir.
So maybe a little more awareness. See, when you see my Sarvangasana, just I'll show you this side. Like this, you can see my elbow. So what I do, I support, see how I'm doing. You see that?
Yes, sir.
Generally, it may be like this. Because if you do like this, you will not get proper height. And your cervical spine will be loaded. When you do this, support, bring it in, really. If you really bring it in, the center neck will be lifted up. And your shoulder will take the load. See here? I'll show you how the shoulder takes the load. Okay?
Yeah, Shiva, one point. I mean, when sometimes you say that remove your hands and stay right the same position, Sarvangasana. How do we stay without hands holding it?
So that is Nirarambha Sarvangasana. So I inhale it up.
Yeah. If I remove hands, then we'll fall down.
How you fall down? Where I'm falling down.
Okay. But I cannot actually hold it. Complete that weight.
See, hands are not around us.
No, but you say that hands should take the weight, right?
So this is normal Sarvangasana, where the support is there. It's called Salambha Sarvangasana. When you keep your hand down, this is called Niralambha Sarvangasana. Niralambha means no support, candle standing.
So then weight is on the neck and the shoulder, right?
Yes, there will be a little weight on the shoulder more, not on the neck. See, I'll show you how the shoulder takes the weight. Now, just observe how it changes. So I'm going to try to show you with the camera. I'll come close to the camera and I'll show you. Okay.
So let me put the mat somewhere here.
Said that sometimes that neck pain will come if we try to.
Wherever the pain comes, don't do too much of it. Okay. So shift the weight to shoulder.
When that pain comes on the neck. Now just see how the shoulder is taking the weight. Okay. I hope I'm visible. Okay.
Yeah.
So I'm taking the weight up. Now, see how the body changes. Now the shoulders are wide, my neck is taking the weight. When I move the shoulder inside, the weight is taken by the shoulder. See, this is neck, this is shoulder. Neck means the cervical spine will touch the floor firm. Yeah. When I take my hip up, now the shoulders are taking full weight. The neck is taking very less. You can see the center neck is elevated. Now I'm going to shift my weight to the neck. See that? The neck came down. It's
okay.
Now here the neck is lifted up. Then the neck will not damage. Now here the shoulder is taking the weight. Or the neck.
Yeah, understood. But I think maybe you are doing it too straight. So.
So you have to gradually improve the straightness so you'll get there.
Yeah, thank you.
Anything else on inversions? Anybody?
Sir, you tell me to in halasana not to bend the knee.
I tell you, correct.
Yeah, what is your question? You don't have a question, huh?
Sir, in halasana my knee bends sometimes.
Not sometimes, every day it is bending. You have to stop where it starts bending. So imagine you are here in Sarvangasana, right? Now you are taking the leg back. Imagine from here your knees are bending like this. Stop here. You don't have to go beyond that. Take it only to the position where your knee doesn't bend. Beyond this position, if your knee is bending, don't take it. Stay here. Got it? Don't do this. Not required. Anything else in inversions? I'm going to back bending sequences. There are.
Hi. Yeah. Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, before like 1 month or something, I was able to do halasana. But now when I do it, like I'm not able to breathe properly.
So what did you change in between last month and this month?
Sir, I don't know. Like suddenly about 1 month before, like I was not able to breathe when I do halasana. It's still there.
Maybe you have gone a little more to the back, a little more. You may have stretched more. Maybe that's the reason you are not able to breathe properly there. Possibility is there.
Okay,
maybe
sir.
You can reduce your push a little and then you will be able to breathe. Okay.
Okay,
try reducing the push.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Who was that? Somebody else was talking.
So from halasana, sometimes my neck feels like turning to the left and right side, but as you say that not to turn it to the left and right side and not turning it.
Yeah, don't turn it. Anvika, right? Anvika, no?
Yes, sir.
You are doing halasana very good. I remember your posture. You are able to straighten the leg, you are able to do it. So in that position, don't turn your neck. If you turn your neck, what will happen? Your neck will sprain. Okay, don't turn it. Keep it safe. Okay, you are doing that very nice. I have seen your halasana.
Okay, sir.
Good.
Sir, in halasana, you always mention to get both the feet together while coming back. The issue what I face is if I touch my feet, then while coming back, I'm not able to get it together. But if I don't touch it and if I lay midway, then I'm able to get it back together.
See, one trick I'll tell you. See, when you do that, don't directly bring it up. So give it, see, as I assume you are in halasana like this. Pull it there, correct? Now, when you come up, don't directly come from there. Come a little back and take it. It's very easy. So from here, if you try to bring it, the weight on the neck will be too high. See, your buttock is above the face almost. And so I don't bring it, you cannot bring it directly from there. You're fully pushed. So after, on the tail of exhale, when I say pancha, inhale, come up. You got that. I did not directly come from there. I brought my hip back little here, keeping the feet there. See, this liver is there in you. So this much playing ground you're having, right? You're pushed, you can come this way and then lift it up. Try shifting the weight towards this side and the leg will automatically come up.
Sure, sir. We'll try that.
Okay. Coming to Matsya, Setubandha. Setubandha Sarvangasana, new introduction this month. Instead of Setubandha Asana, this month we are doing Setubandha Sarvangasana. It's a different asana. Then Chakra, Paramukta Asana, Dhanurasana, Hanumanasana, Balasana, Parvatasana. In one series I am going to do that. All of them. Otherwise I will be delayed. All that in one series. I will finish only after the Hanumanasana and Balasana. Samasthiti. First Matsyasana. Inhaling, keep the legs together. Palm on the mat and exhale. What's the first step that's important? Inserting the arms below the buttocks. Ekam, inhale, insert the arms below the buttocks. See, did you see that? The arm has gone below the buttocks. Elbow also went. It is not like this. I did not say hand below the buttocks. I said arm, arm below. Arm is different, hand is different. Hand is this much. This to this is hand. Full, this is arm. This is hand. This full hand, this is not hand. This much only. This is arm. So insert the arm below the buttocks. So I insert the arm. And then I exhale. So the arm is below. Then only the next position is easy. Dvi, inhaling, lift the upper body on the elbow. See, very easy. Because your elbow is below the body, below the buttock. Then exhaling, bulge and put the head back. Matsyasana. Inhale. Exhale. One more breath I take. Two breaths over. Inhale, head up. Exhale, body down, head down. Inhale, take the arms out. And exhale. Setubandha Sarvangasana. Inhale. Where is the mic? Oh, here. Inhale. Exhale. Point the toe. Ekam, inhale, bend the legs. Keep them away. Dvi, exhale, catch. Ankle with your hand. Three, inhale, hips up. On the exhalation, insert one pillar. Inhale, insert the other pillar. And then exhale, walk. Setubandha Sarvangasana. Inhale. Two breaths only here. Using our own body to arch the back. One more. Raising nose. Two. Inhale, walk. Exhale, palm by the ear. Inhale, chakra. One. Two. Three. Shavasana relax. Setu Bandha Sarvangasana. After that, Kavana Muktasana. Samasthiti. Inhale, legs together, hands close to body. Exhale, be ready. Ekam, bend the knee, hug the knees. Do exhale, chin on the knee. One, two breaths are over. Three, inhale, head down. Exhale. Inhale, right arm over the head, bend the left. Exhale, turn. Inhale, stretch your arms in front. Exhale, legs together. Dhanurasana kami. Inhale, bend your legs up. Keep them away. Exhale, catch angle. Inhale, pick your body, upper body and thighs in the air. One. Two. Three. Exhale. Inhale, release the hands. Sorry, legs. And exhale, fold your arms. Now three prone breaths here. I'll take one. See the depth of my breathing. I hope you can hear the sound. After finishing both the sides, inhale, palm by the chest. I'm waiting for the VIP breath. Then exhale, join the leg. Inhale, come up on the knees and hands. Exhale. Hanumanasana, one side will show. Inhale, step the left foot in front. If your bricks are there, it's easy. I'll show without the bricks. Look forward. On the exhalation, slip the leg in front of you. So let it go in front of the mat. Hanumanasana. Inhale. Exhale. One. Two. Three. Inhale, pull the leg back till the hand position. Exhale, take it to cat. Repeating that on the other side also. After coming back, Inhale, sit up. Exhale and go to Vajra. Inhale here. Exhale, go to Balasana. Five prone breath here. After five breath, inhale, sit up. Exhale, interlock the finger. Inhale, stretch the arms. Three breaths in the pose. I'll take one. Exhale, hand down. Then what is the advanced asana in this class? Bakasana. Then I'll take a break for your questions. So how to do Bakasana? Bricks, if there are bricks, it's easy to do in Bakasana. Otherwise, little difficult. So with bricks, I'll show you how to do Bakasana. How to shift the weight in front. This month, advanced asana is that. See, dip the body and bring the knee on the armpit. Dip it and bring it on the armpit. See? I don't start here. I go deep. After that, keep the hands on the bricks. Lift the heels up. So where is the knee? Knee is here. That's how you have to do Bakasana. Don't do it like this. Keep it deep. Lift the heel up. Then you get the grip. Take one leg up. Gradually take the other. So the taller the better. You can also do like this also. If you find it tough, keep the knee outside the arm like this and just try to lift it. This is also fine. You can do like this. Beginners. It's easier to do like that. What I showed you is a difficult method. I mean the advanced method. You can do this way, so it's easier. You have to balance like this. So that is Bakasana. Any queries on the asanas? Otherwise, I will go to pranayama section. In advanced class, there is Ashtavakrasana. Other than what I explained, Ashtavakrasana is there. I will show you that, then we will go to the questions. In Ashtavakrasana, you stand like your Bakasana position only. Insert one hand below the thigh, left side I'm showing. And then this is insertion. Then cross the other leg above this leg. Then straighten it, bend the elbow. Ashtavakrasana. You should not touch the floor, everything is in the air. Like that. Ashtavakrasana. Ashtavakrasana means 8 angled posture. Okay. So I explained all the asanas. Before I go to pranayama, any questions on whatever I showed in the last sequence?
Sir, in Chakrasana, I'm not able to put my hands down in hands. I'm able to put the hands, but the elbows not able to go inside. I'm facing problem in that.
It's okay, ma. You are Chakrasana. You are able to lift it up, no? I have seen you lifting up Chakrasana. You are able to lift up, I think, right, Manvika?
Yes, sir.
Don't worry. Gradually, your strength of the arms will increase, and with time passing by, few more months, you'll be able to do that better. Your progress is good. I've been observing you. Don't worry. You'll improve the strength of your arms and you'll get there slowly. Okay?
Anvika. Yes, sir.
Good. There were a few questions which one was from, I think, Pooja. She has mentioned that. Will the spinal movements and the strengthen the spine and the core? See, spinal movements are not going to improve the core strength.
For example, if you do, say, Paschimottanasana, it's a forward bend. Or Chakrasana is a backward bend. This improves the strength of the arms. So when you do Chakrasana, the arms, trapezius muscles, all these muscles become stronger. And the flexibility of the backbone will increase. The stomach muscles are stretching. It is not strengthening the core muscles. I mean, the abdominal or the core. See, the core muscle strengthening comes in asanas like, say, Chaturanga, where you connect. There is a strength building here. Say, for example, when you do Navasana. Now here, now you are catching the weight through this connection. There is a tightness building here through the core muscles. So these are the asanas that will strengthen the core. See, if you do Bhujangasana, which is a back bending, or do Paschimottanasana, they are not going to develop the core muscles. It has got different effects. Whereas when you do in Surya Namaskara, this plank. Now this is connection. There is a core action. When you do Chaturanga, there is a core strength. So all these asanas which connect through this core or the middle of the body, and there is a tightness you feel here, they are the asanas which will develop your core muscles. Asanas like, say, Chakrasana or Paschimottanasana, any asanas which there is a flexion or extension of the spine, they may not be really, you know, helping to develop the core muscles. This is what I could understand from your question. And does the belly fat affect? Yes, belly fat will affect forward bending. When you do a forward bending asana, like say Paschimottanasana or any asana for that matter, the first the stomach touches the thigh. You can see here. If you remember, I have a little, not too much of fat. If I put on 5 kgs of weight, automatically my forward bending capability will reduce. Because it will obstruct me. I will not be able to bend. Because my pet will touch my pet. And it will be difficult to go. So, stomach fat definitely will prevent you or reduce your
Thank you, sir. Bye, sir.
Sir, no sound.
So we are not able to hear you.
Sir, even I can't hear you. Suddenly the voice went.
Sir, I couldn't hear you before sometime.
Suddenly the voice.
Now is it audible?
Yes, sir. Now it's
audible. Yeah. Till when could you hear me? I was talking about core muscles. Was I audible that time?
Yes, sir. You're audible.
Yes, sir. Now only some seconds before I just
logged out and logged out. So I think that mic went off. I'm sorry for that. Okay. So I talked to you about the second part which I spoke was regarding the belly fat. Did you hear me talking that?
Yes, sir.
Sir, again your voice went.
Sir, no sound.
I can't hear you now.
Is it audible now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I think that,
yes, sir. Now it's audible.
So I have completed all that. Now I'm going to talk to you about pranayama.
Sir, one quick question.
Yeah.
Sir, in Dhanurasana, what is normally observed is I'm able to lift the chest very well, but when it comes to lifting the thighs, I generally feel there is too much of a pressure to lift it up. Not able to lift it to the extent where what my chest is lifting. So is there any way to improve that? Yes. That is first one.
Okay.
And second last question is, how do I improve the strength of my arms or shoulders? Because Bakasana I've been trying to do for several months now, but I develop severe pain when I do this one. For that reason, even when I do Mayurasana also, I develop pain in my arms and shoulders basically.
Your arms and shoulders are hurting when you do Bakasana?
Yes.
Okay. I think probably the strength, it comes with, you know, maybe a little more time. So when you keep on doing, gradually the strength improves. So maybe that, you know, your muscles are getting overstrained when you're doing a Bakasana. What happens is, when you practice Surya Namaskara, so you try to do that Chaturanga always, all the rounds. When you do that, I think you're able to do it, Chaturanga, this low plank.
Yes, sir. I'm doing this throughout, sir. Throughout, I'm on Chaturanga only.
So keep practicing that. With time passing, see, it takes time because, it's our own body. So it will take time for those, you know, shoulders, all these muscles to improve. Shoulder strength, upper body strength is very important for what I spoke about. Bakasana, all your, you were speaking of Nanmurasana. All these needs upper body strength. So we'll have to give it a little time so that you don't have to, don't push too much that your shoulders are start paining. So once you feel, okay, I'm not able to, then just leave it. Then go to the next day, practice again. Keep on doing that. I think it's the time gradually you'll be able to get that improvement of the upper body strength. Then the other question which you asked was regarding Dhanurasana. So when you lift your body in the air, so don't lift the chest too much. If you do too much of chest, then the leg will not come up. So keep your chest a little low and lift the thigh. In Dhanurasana, the back, the thigh has to lift up. So keep your chest a little low and lift your head up. I mean, thighs are like that. Don't do this way. If you do that, it will spoil the asana. And you find below the abdomen, those organs will start pressing and it will hurt you also. So don't do that. Take the stomach on the floor. Don't keep lower abdomen or upper abdomen. Try to keep the entire stomach on the floor when you lift up. And tighten the arm. You have to pull the leg up, tightening the arm. So tighten the arm and pull your leg up this way. You'll get there. So try not to lift the chest. Try to lift the leg up like that.
Sridhar here. Today you had shared one video for strengthening of your neck and this one, right?
Yeah.
So when we lift my hand and keep it on our chest, then automatically that full crown is not touching the floor.
So the placement of the crown is the trick of this asana.
So it slips and just only the back of the crown is on the floor. When we take our hand and then keep it above.
The way you keep your crown is the trick of it. And second thing is, don't bend the legs too much. Little bend it. This much only. Don't keep like this. Then you will not be able to lift up. Keep it here. I think I explained that in the video. Little gap and little shallow mountain, not very tall. And then when you keep the crown, don't keep the center here or the front. You have to keep the little at the back. So like this. You see this? Which is the part touching? I hope you can see. It's the back of the crown, not the center of the crown.
Okay, it's back only, is it? Because I'm trying to keep center, so I'm getting pain at the neck.
Keep center, then you cannot lift up.
Okay.
Can't be able to lift. See, after lifting, the crown will come. You have to start from the back, so when you roll, the center will come. Look at it. See, I kept the back. Okay, little back. Then I cross. Now look at my crown, how is it going to move? I lift my hip up. Now the crown came. So that.
Okay. So it is just rolling, is it? Not moving our neck inward.
No, I just take my weight over my head.
Okay.
I hope you can see me clearly.
Yeah. Because I tried to pull the head inward, so there I got that full crown was not on.
Here you cannot keep here. See, I rolled, little strength is required on the neck. So it's more of technique. It's nothing to do much of strength here. More of technique, where you keep it, how much you keep the leg, all that is important here.
Okay, I'll start watching my leg when I'm pushing it. Thank you, sir.
Okay. So this month, the pranayamas are Bhastrika and Vibhagiya pranayama, sectional breathing. These two I'll explain. And other than this, did I get any questions? Yeah. I think Renu had asked a question regarding Kumbhaka. Nija was there. Anybody else? Questions I missed? Okay. See, in Kumbhaka.
Sir, one last question I had in handstand. Sir, where should be the drishti be in handstand and in Vrikshikasana also?
Yeah, in Vrishti, all these are forward facing. Ekakri drishti front.
Okay, sir.
In handstand also forward look, Vrikshikasana forward look.
Okay, sir.
Because it's a balancing pose. You cannot look on anything on the body. Any balancing poses, the drishti will be outside the body. It cannot be hand, leg, nose. Eyebrow, not possible. Balancing poses, the point of look will be outside the body. It will be generally in front of you. All the balance. Ekagra drishti.
Sir, even I had a question.
Yeah.
You, yes, when I lift my leg and when I come down, my hip also come down a little bit.
Okay, you'll improve, don't worry, okay? Bring more mind focus in the class. Hmm?
Okay.
Bhastrika means bell. Before that, was I speaking something? No. Bhastrika pranayama or bellow breath. It's better to sit Vajrasana when you do Bhastrika. It's a chest acting movement. Brahma mudra, thumb inside the palm. Around the thumb, you have to wrap all the fingers. Back of the wrist on a thigh. Pushing this hand, the chest will lift. Tanmay, what you're doing, I'll show you what you're doing. Your chest is not moving, your back is moving. It will damage you. Don't do that. See, this action happens on back, straight back. Don't do this. Please try to realize, clear your mind. It is not a backbone breath. Nothing to do with the backbone action. The chest rises. The chest will rise. Look, see, do you find any change in the height of my back? Observe. Only chest is bulging. The work of the spine is to support that action. What you're doing is like this. You're moving the entire back. It will damage you. Don't do these things. I've told you many times. If you're not able to do it, just forget about it. Don't do anything. See, instead of damaging yourself, just don't do it. First you analyze, okay, this is what it is. Okay, let me clear my mind. Once you pick it up, practice. Till that time, don't damage yourself. Okay. So Bhastrika is a chest breath, pushing this hand on the thigh. The chest is rising. Observe this point. Let me show you the wrong technique. What is this? This is shoulder exercise. This is not at all Bhastrika. Okay, some people do it like this, like this. This to some extent will help, but it is more of an exercise of the arm. I'm doing Bhastrika now. I'll show you this method, but my chest will not move. Observe this. Does it look like Bhastrika? Yes, right? My chest is not rising. I'm just lifting my arm and bring. The danger of this is that. If your chest is rising along with that action, I'm good with that. So the focus is on upper body, the chest rising. Look at the chest. That's why I don't do that. Because that camouflages, no? It camouflages your effect. It gives you a false feeling that, yes, I'm doing Bhastrika. So I don't recommend doing that. So in my class, I do only this way. So this lifts up, this. That is Bhastrika pranayama. We do 70 rounds of that. And then we go to Vibhagiya pranayama, sectional breathing. Three steps and then finally mix all the three. First is abdominal breath, keeping one hand on the stomach. So how do you do that? Observe my stomach, how the stomach comes out. I'll keep my left hand so it is visible to you. Abdomen coming forward. going inside, bulging it. Let me do one more round. Breathe in front and exhale. That's called abdominal breathing, Adho Shvasana. That's the first part in Vibhagiya Shvasana. The second part is thoracic breathing. So I keep my hands like this. Then when I inhale, I spread my ribs apart. Did you observe the hand movement? Bringing it closer. Sideways expansion. So you can actually see how my ribs are going out. Vibhagiya Shvasana. We do 5 times this. Then last one, Adi Shvasana or clavicular breath. I lift the arms and lift my chest. More than the arm, the chest has lift. See, the chest has gone up. So I reverse the palm direction also. Three times this also. Then normal breathing, keep the hands in Dhyana Mudra. Then mix all the three things, stomach, thoracic, clavicular. So first stomach comes out, but don't use the hand. Put the chin down. So stomach, chest, and then up. Observe again. Came up. Not shoulder. Don't do this. That's not required. Chest is different, shoulder is different. So that's called mixing all the three. Three-dimensional breath.
Sir?
Yeah.
So you're using Ujjayi breath here, right?
Yes. Perfect. You got right. So that completes your Ujjayi pranayama. And then you do Omkar sitting in the sitting position and then Shavasana. How do you do the Omkara? A, U and Ma. Take an in breath. Natural, the voice dies down. That way we'll be doing 7 times. A, U, Ma in one Umpa, 7 times. And then you do Shavasana. There was another question from Renu, which was about Kumbhaka.
Yes, sir.
So the different broad categories of Kumbhaka is, that's where it branches. One is Kevala Kumbhaka, one is Sahita Kumbhaka. Kevala means automatic. So which happens naturally. For example, after you do Kapalabhati Bastrika, the body would not like to breathe for some time, right? I'm sure you're getting that. Maybe 5 seconds, 10 seconds. So that time the body on its own, Kevala means on its own or simple or automatic Kumbhaka. When the body itself holds the breath or the need of breath becomes very, very less, that is called Kevala Kumbhaka. That is first branch. Other branch is called Sahita. Hita means choice, right? We do our choice. Sahita. With our choice, we choose to hold the breath. For example, when you do this month, in the month of May, we are doing Ujjayi Pranayama, right? So I inhale. Now I am holding the breath for 6 seconds purposefully with my will. I am holding the breath 6 seconds. After 6 seconds, I release the breath. So, with my choice, I hold the breath. That is called Sahita Kumbhaka. Sahita Kumbhaka. So, within Sahita Kumbhaka, there can be internal Sahita Kumbhaka, external Sahita Kumbhaka, means internally purposefully you are holding, externally purpose we are holding, all these sub branches can come. So these are, this is what is Sahita Kumbhaka and Kevala Kumbhaka. They are opposite to each other.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Anything else? Otherwise, I will close the class. Because 5:45 to open the next class. Another 4 minutes I have. Any other questions, anybody?
No, sir. Thank you very much.
Watch the session again. If you have doubts, come 1st June. Please be prepared. Once you know, you plan, then it's easy. Otherwise, if you land and then start learning, then it will take a little difficult. Okay? So try to, and then we close the prayer. Inhale, take the arms over the head. Take the heart. So heart is here. So many of you are giving here. So keep it here. And back straight. See, again, Tanmay is not straight. See, these are the fundamentals. First you have to learn these things. Then only worry about other things. Okay? Then. All of us. Ananta sansara samudra tara naukaitabhyam guru bhakti tabhyam vairagya samrajyada pujanabhyam namo namaha sri guru padukabhyam namo namaha sri guru padukabhyam om shanti shanti shanti. Gently go down. Thank God for today's practice. Come back. Thank you. Namaste. Take care.
Thank you, sir. Bye, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Bye,
thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Bye, sir.